been doing? I'm Anime Intensity, and welcome back to my channel. Sorry I took a very unintentional hiatus. I am so sorry. It's been like 4 weeks since I uploaded my last video, but you know what? My last video was a Junji the No Longer Human review, and he actually liked my tweet when I tweeted about it on Twitter. I was like, hey, I made a video on No Longer Human, and I tagged him, and he actually liked the tweet. So you know what? Bucket list fulfilled. But anyway, those 4 weeks... it just kind of snowballed. It was a snowball situation. It started off as something, and the next thing you know, it's like, I didn't upload for 4 weeks, and it really pains me. I feel so bad. I'm sorry, guys, and I hope that some of you missed me. I hope you guys did. I hope you missed my videos. That's more like it. I actually had the flu for those first 2 weeks. It was totally bad, and now I understand when people say, like, people have died from the flu. I'm like, I understand, because I felt like that. I was there. I was at 104 degrees for about 3 days, and I couldn't get out of bed. I actually couldn't get out of bed for, like, 2 weeks. So it was just a very exhausting experience, and then I took Tamiflu and had an allergic reaction to Tamiflu as well. So you know what? Those 2 weeks, I was just out. I was done. That's it. And then after that, I ended up going back to school, of course, and so getting adjusted to a new schedule always... It's a lot of work, okay, guys? So I really apologize for taking this unintentional hiatus. I didn't expect it at all. And having this cloudy weather every day just kind of brings me down. But anyway, today we're actually going to be having my January 2020 favorites. And I have, you know, many of these things are like, yeah, good stuff. Like, these were my highlights for January. Definitely way better than the things that happened to me in January. So you know what? I'm happy about that. So if you had anything for January 2020 that you really enjoyed, feel free to comment below. Let me know what you really liked for the month. But anyway, let's get started with my favorites, and let's start off with manga. So, my favorite manga for the month of January is actually volume 2 of a series that I did a manga first take for, so you've seen the first volume in my review, possibly, but this is actually volume 2 of Bakemonogatari. I read this few weeks ago, and I was like, I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. I am so glad that Bakemonogatari is having a manga adaptation, especially done by Oh Great. I mean, come on, you can't get any better than that. So this is released by Vertical Comics, and I have to admit, it's a really, you know, it's a different perspective when it comes to Bakemonogatari, when, you know, whether if you've watched the anime or read the light novels. You know, this offers another view, and especially seeing this kind of artwork, you know, from Oh Great. First of all, it's beautiful. It's great. This is like seeing your favorite characters in Oh Great's art style is really cool. So I really like this volume because, of course, my favorite Mayoi Hachiguchi. But anyway, she's so sweet. I love her. I don't know about sweet, but she's like my favorite character. Besides. I have favorite characters when it comes to Bakemonogatari. There's just so many people that you love. But anyway, I really recommend reading this manga if you are a fan of Bakemonogatari. And if you've never read, watched anything Bakemonogatari or Monogatari at all, then I really recommend starting with the manga because it has like some supernatural elements, there's fan service, it's a fun story, it's different, and good stuff. So I really recommend this, and I really was happy with that second volume. Now, moving along, I was actually reading another book, and this is not like a book that's a classic. You're not going to find it on your top 10 books of all time. But you know what? It's a fun read, and I feel like it's appropriate because the movie, you know, Birds of Prey just came out. Harley Quinn Mad Love. So this is not the comic version. This is actually the novelization. So this isn't actually providing, like, any new insight, I have to admit. There's some cool things that maybe you didn't know before, but it's a fun read because you're reading Harley Quinn's origin story, you know, maybe for the first time or the second time or whatever, and once again, it's a different perspective. Rather than reading from the comics or watching the cartoon or whatever, it's just another adaptation, and has a lot of different things, and, you know, even though there's a lot of familiar things, there's some different things, and it's just very engaging. So I really, really like this book, and I love the cover too. And I don't know, I'm telling you, I'm definitely a DC girl. I'm not a Marvel girl. I like X-Men and Wolverine from Marvel, but like, I don't read Marvel comics. I read only primarily DC. But then when it comes to X-Men and Wolverine, I'm there. So then I'm there for Marvel. But most of the time, I'm there for DC. I haven't seen Birds of Prey yet, but I do want to go see it. If any of you have seen it, tell me how it was. I hope it was good. But yeah. Anyway, moving along, I actually have some stickers that I want to show you guys. And you probably are like, what? Stickers? Really? Like, of all things, you want to show us stickers? Let me put my glasses on because I actually can't see them. And I'm telling you, I'm blind, okay, guys? And so I actually got these stickers from Natty Cat Pins. So this is totally blurry. I hope that it, you know what? Okay. Well, it's upside down. Even better. So these stickers are actually by Natty Cat Pins. And I can't see what it says on the card because I have it on the camera thing and it's backwards. Your day just got a little bit cuter. And yes, it did. I definitely think it did. But anyway, let me show you guys what stickers I got. But anyway, this is the first one. You guys know I love Junjito, right? So this is from Uzumaki. I love it so much. And I like how the sticker is holographic. So this is actually like one of my new favorite stickers or favorite things of all time. I just absolutely love it. I also ended up getting this one, not anime related, but I love my horror stuff. So I got this little ghost face. I love it so much. So cute. I really, really like it. And I ended up getting this one too. This is my favorite sticker now. Like, I absolutely love it. This is like the alien kitty. And it's holographic. It's cool. It's different. I'm trying to get it a little sharper. This is my favorite thing. I don't want to put it on anything because I love it so much. But it's a really nice sticker. I absolutely love it. I ended up getting a free sticker because I purchased three. There was like a deal. And I actually put it inside my binder. Not binder. Why do I call this a binder? Every time I see it, I'm like, this is my binder. My clipboard. My clipboard for my job. And I put my stickers inside because I don't want people to, you know, why do you have that on it? You can't have that on this. So I have it inside. So when I open my binder. When I open my clipboard, I can have a little bit of happiness. Yeah, I got this one, this last one here. Fighting Dreamer, yeah, so after the best OP from Naruto. So yeah, I have that here. I love, once again, it's glittery, it's shiny, it's really, really well done. And I want to order more stickers from this store already. And I, you know, like I just got these, like, hold on. But yeah, I really love her designs and I'm just happy. So yeah. Things that I've been watching since I realized I haven't talked about those yet. Speaking of Fighting Dreamer and Naruto, Pluto TV actually has their own Naruto channel now. So they just play Naruto 24/7. I don't think that they play like Shippuden. Like, they just play like regular Naruto. And I have been guilty. I have been watching this thing like right before bed. I watch like who knows how many episodes and I'm like, oh my god, I really love this. Like, it just reminded me how much I loved that series when it was originally airing. You know, I was like in what, 8th grade, 7th grade, I don't even know when. But, you know, the point is, I really, really was a huge fan back then. And now I'm remembering why I was such a huge fan. And a lot of people say so many things about Naruto and they're like, oh, it's not cool, oh, ha ha. You know, like, they make fun of the series as a whole. But listen, some of the things are fire. Like, but you don't understand, like, some of the arcs are like, ho, I'm telling you. They are so engaging, they're fun to watch, they're silly, and yes, they do play the fillers too, so if you miss any of the fillers, they're there, but it's just, I really like it, and I'm reliving, like, so many memories, and at least this time, I'm not sitting in front of my laptop for, like, 6 hours on YouTube watching Naruto in 3 parts, so it's good to watch it legally on Pluto TV through the app, so, yeah, how times have changed, but anyway, yeah, I've been watching that. Definitely, you know, nothing new, but it's just become a favorite once again. And then next thing you know, another thing that I really enjoyed, another anime, of course, is Dororo. I just finished Dororo a couple of days ago, and man, that series is so good. It's a shame that it's on Amazon Prime because I feel like nobody goes on Amazon Prime for anime. And I feel like it could have gotten way more exposure if it wasn't on Amazon Prime. Unfortunately, it was. But it is such a great series with such lovable characters. And Miyake Maru actually just, they announced an actual scale figure at Wonder Festival. That's actually what I wanted to do today, look at figures. But I saw the figure and I was like, yes, this is the moment I've been waiting for. Not the Nendoroid, I want a full scale figure of Miyake Maru. But anyway, it's just a really awesome story about this boy who's just trying to get his body back and his journey fighting demons and getting his body parts one by one. It's really interesting. I'm telling you, it has action. It has feels. It has so much to it. And I really recommend the series as a whole. Maybe I'll do a review. I don't know. It's been a while since I did an anime review, so I feel a little bit rusty. But it's such a great anime, and if you haven't watched it already, please, please, please do. You will definitely enjoy it, and I absolutely love it. So that was my favorite anime for the month of January. An actual series that I watched in January that is not anime is actually Giri Haji on Netflix, and this show is about like the Yakuza. It's like this guy is a detective from Japan and his brother goes missing and he has to go find his brother and stuff like that. And his brother has a lot of secrets and there's just like a bunch of things going on and boom, boom. And like, you know, like it's a lot of stuff. So it's a lot of action and has a lot of mature themes and stuff like that. So if you're underage or shouldn't be watching that kind of stuff, I know you probably will anyway, but just a heads up for those people. Last but not least is probably the one thing that you guys have been waiting for this entire video. This is my favorite art book now of like all time, although I can't really say that because I technically have like three favorite art books, and that's this one, my Clamp one, my Yu-Gi-Oh! Art book, and soon my Junji Ito Twisted Visions art book, which is coming out very soon, and that means I have four favorite art books. But anyway, this is Return to Avalon, Fate Artworks. I was trying to read, but once again, no glasses. I was like, I cannot see this. But anyway, this is an amazing art book. This is a hardcover art book featuring art from Fate over many, many years. This has art from like Fate Grand Order, the Fate anime, the, you know, everything, the visual novel. Like, it has artwork from everything. And so, let me tell you, this book is definitely kind of heavy. It's worth maybe like, I got it for like $70, I would have to say, $70. But that was with shipping. I don't know how much it is without shipping. I forgot, maybe like $50. But it's definitely worth every single penny. It's gorgeous and features some of my like favorite illustrations. I don't know if you can see this, but I will definitely show you more. Oh, it's so beautiful. I love it so much. So you see Saber, you see Sakuramato, you see Rinpozaka, you see just everybody, and it's just a great collection of such a beloved franchise, and I absolutely recommend that art book. If you like art books, this is the one that you want. If you like Fate at all, this is what you want. If you can find a copy, get it. I highly, highly recommend. But anyway, those are my favorites for January 2020. I hope you guys enjoyed this month's video. If you had any favorites for the month of January, feel free to comment below and let me know what you really enjoyed. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Totally, totally appreciate it. Feel free to like, share, comment, or subscribe if you like this video. And I will see you guys next time.